Hello everyone, I'm Caleb with Danzy Design Build, and today we're finishing a basement in Draper, Utah. And we're working on the rough in here, and part of that is the electrical. So today I wanted to talk to you a little bit about the electrical components and some of the things that we might have to do on a basement finish, and just give a little bit of context and information as to upgrading some certain electrical components when you add a lot of electrical to your basement for a kitchen or a bathroom, and a lot of electrical appliances like the range, the stove, you know, the dryers and other things that consume a lot of electricity. So let's just jump right in here and take a look. Okay, so right here we're looking at the exterior of the home and the electrical meter and the main panel that comes from the street into the house. And so right down here, you'll notice this conduit, which is this gray pipe that comes up from underground and into this box. That's what supplies the meter with power. And that's where the power gets counted, and that's where your electrical bill actually gets generated from. And then inside this box, the power comes around to this side after it's been measured and gets distributed to the house through these breakers. And so this is a 200 amp service breaker. So this is feeding the sub panel inside the house, which has all the breakers for everything inside the home. The only things that are not on this sub panel are the air conditioners here and here. There's a 20 amp and a 30 amp. So basically the whole entire house is running off of this 200 amp breaker. And that is going through a 4-aught cable, and we'll show that inside and where that goes from this meter box into the actual sub panel inside. So we'll take a look at that. So we're inside the home now, and we're just about right where the main cable comes in from the meter box outside, and that's this gray one here. It's a 4-aught, so it's a very large cable that carries all that 200 amps and goes clear down through this area in the ceiling, and then comes down here, and you can see it enter right here into the mechanical room, and then it ties into this panel here. And so this is the sub panel in the basement, and you can see here that this is pretty much full of breakers. So the thing is, this is supplied with 200 amps from the one outside, so we have plenty of power for this home, but we don't have enough space for all the new circuits that we need to add for the actual basement. So there are a couple of options that you could do here. The first one is to add another sub panel, which is what we're going to be doing. And the second one is to twin up a lot of these breakers so that it has the double. You can see there's the 20-20, and then this one's a single 20. So you can fit more of them in here. So depending on your electrical design, the square footage of your home, and the amount of circuits that you'll actually need, that can actually really be a good way to go if you don't have space for another panel, or if there's some other constraints for your particular situation. So if you need help finishing your basement or remodeling your home, you can reach us on our website, danzydesignbuild.com, and request a consultation there. We'll reach right back out to you, and we look forward to hearing from you. Thanks, and have a great week. Talk to you later. Bye.